Have you ever compared unfinished furniture to finished furniture? When you do, you'll see how you can own beautiful, quality furniture and save as much as 50%.
At Country Woods, you'll save on a large selection of first quality solid wood furniture for every room in the house. Living room, dining room, kitchen, and bedroom furniture in a variety of woods ready to be finished. You'll save at Country Woods Unfinished Furniture Outlet, Route 101 Raymond, where you get low prices naturally.
New Hampshire fur bearers are a renewable resource. Trapping is an important tool used to manage this resource. Responsible trappers are knowledgeable about wildlife, maintain equipment in good working order, and always get landowner permission before the season. This is Eric Orff, wildlife biologist, reminding you that the Fishing Department sponsors trapper education courses. For more information, call 271-3212.
Weeknights, your evenings will sparkle on TV 50. At 6:30, put the laughs in park with Taxi.
Let's get him a job.
What kind of training could he possibly have?
None.
What kind of skills can he possibly have?
None.
What kind of job can we possibly get him?
Then at 7, the gang's all here for WKRP in Cincinnati.
It just so happens that because of the cold, our general sales manager, Herbert R. Tarlick Jr., has lost all feeling in his lower extremities.
At 7:30, it's great families, great moments, and great fun with the Family Feud. And at 8, the adventure continues with Star Trek.
Sir, contact with an object. It's moving toward us.
This is the United Earthship Enterprise. We convey greetings and await your reply.
At 9, there's Exotic Adventure with Hawaii 5-0, followed by TV 50 News at 10. With such a great lineup, your weeknights are sure to sparkle on TV 50.
Heard the official announcement. The referee now giving instructions. Bob Van Winkle, and he'll do battle against Gino Brito Jr. Boy, what a name he's making for himself. His dad training him, and later on in this program, we'll be seeing... I should say later on, weeks to come, we'll be seeing Gino's dad making a few appearances throughout the New England area. International wrestling. Moves on the part of Junior. Both men lock up. Arm bar applied. Pressure applied. Moves by Gino Brito Jr. Roll over by Bob Van Winkle. He reverses it, gets him down. He looks for the count. Here's the count. Count of one. Referee breaks. One count. Both men getting ready to tie up. As Gino Brito Jr. is coming along, there's a kick to the stomach by Van Winkle. There's the count, one, two, no. Oh! Rougeau Jr. A little hair pulling here. Referee goes into it, breaks the hold. Brito Jr. applying the pressure. Pushes him up against the ropes. There he goes, a little push off. Moves here by Gino Brito Jr. He's going to apply a little pressure to this arm. Takes the leg across, really comes down hard on it. We heard the ooze from here from Van Winkle. Referee check, and Van Winkle still able to carry on, reaches for the rope, puts his foot on a rope. Referee breaks the hold. Good move by Van Winkle. There we go. Takes him, throws him up against the rope. Takes him. Beautiful move. Back pressure to that arm, and that Van Winkle is just going off. When is he going to stop? Two count on Van Winkle. Van Winkle's biting here. He's actually biting his leg. Referee coming in there. Van Winkle's swearing, not me. I didn't bite nothing. He's arguing here with the referee. We can actually see the marks on Brito Jr.'s leg. Down by Van Winkle. A few kicks here to the knee. I tell you, that gets punishing after a while. Look at him twist that foot. Holding the pressure with the other foot. Vicious elbow across the leg. Is Van Winkle starting to pick up a name here from the audience? They're starting to call him Bowwinkle. Aggravates him a little bit. Vicious knee. Seems he hurt himself. Applies the pressure to Brito Jr. Punch, kick, another kick, and another. Oh, forearm, another forearm. This crowd is going wild here. Applied. They both lock up. Headlock. Beautiful reversal. Through the legs and down he takes them. Applying the pressure here. Elbow. Of Brito Jr. in a bit of a problem. Here we go, a little maneuver here by Brito Jr. Turns him right off, a little trunk pulling here. Whoa, he kicks him right off. Nice move by Jr. More pressure applied to the leg. Ooh, flying body right across the leg. Brito's getting a lot of pressure on that leg. It's really starting to get to him here. Vicious slap to the chest. Wicked punch. Oh, look at this crowd saying give it to him, but he keeps applying pressure to that leg. This Van Winkle is a very shrewd man. He knows he has him in a bit of predicament, and he is using it to his availability. Oh, takes him, flies him right out of the ring, goes Junior. A lot of pain in his leg. Van Winkle walking around the ring like he owns the world right now. What do you want? Vicious elbow by Van Winkle. Down goes Junior.
Send in paper an official and an official from the immigration to assist New York across the border so we will have no more excuses. Very slowly, ladies and gentlemen, is the point of making a return trip to the president's position to all American boys.
Van Winkle has him down, applying pressure. Referee checking, no choke. Takes him over. Nice move by Brito Jr. This Van Winkle. I tell you, this Brito Jr. took a lot of air. He goes back to that leg. Good move by Van Winkle. You got to give him credit. He knows he has Junior in trouble with that leg, and he's using it. Junior trying to get some circulation in there. Exciting international wrestling coming throughout the New England, and we even are happy to say throughout the New England, New York, New Jersey, and the Pennsylvania areas. So call your friends and let them know we're coming. Ric Flair, Dusty Rhodes, the Freebirds, the Rock and Roll Express, and many, many more. Body slam by Junior. Elbow. Down. Nope, I thought he was going for the cover. Off the ropes. Oh, Valentine moves out of the way, and back pain back in the leg that... I keep calling him Valentine, and it's Van Winkle.
After this match, Thursday, make sure you're the first. Yeah, but after this match...
right after this.
Forearm by Van Winkle. Another shot. A knee to the stomach. Junior giving it to Spertus. Van Winkle has given him one heck of a time. Taking him, toes, rips him into the turf. Vicious turnbuckle. Oh, good move. Look at Van Winkle. He went over three times. Devastating, and another shot. Van Winkle sees the world spinning in front of him. Wow, we heard that from here. And the crowd is going, go, go get him. And look, oh, this Van Winkle just doesn't die. Brito takes him. Look at the crowd going, go, oh, vicious move. Junior goes for the pin. One, two, no, two count. Little hair pulling here by Junior. Rams him into the turnbuckle. Reversal by Van Winkle. Here he comes charging. He threw the knee to nobody. There goes Junior. He knows he's got it, his momentum going now. He's giving him some punishment. This crowd is going to get him. Figure four. The figure four leg lock applied. That's it. That is it. The winner of the match, Gino Brito Jr.
Now, the floor covering sale that cuts your cost in half. It's Dean's Carpet Spectacular Half Price Sale. Half price on many national brands of carpeting. Half price on color carpet remnants. Half price on a select group of oriental rugs. And half price on no-wax vinyl. Get half price on Ultron by Monsanto and their exclusive 5-year wear-dated guarantee. Yes, Dean's Carpet has half price savings store-wide. Cut your floor covering cost in half at Dean's Carpet across from the Mall of New Hampshire in Manchester.
This man makes his living writing fairy tales like this one. About a glorious vacation house, big and beautiful. All yours just for sending a small deposit. Well, hundreds of people believed this tale and sent their money to a mail fraud operator, a specialist in vacation cons and get-rich-quick schemes. If you suspect mail fraud, call your postal inspector or local postmaster. If something sounds too good to be true, it probably is.
There are all kinds of places where kids can get introduced to drugs, like marijuana, alcohol, and cocaine. I'm Michael Landon, and that happened to one of my kids. Oh, she's okay now. But it wasn't easy for me to find out about these drugs. But fortunately, that's changed. Pharmacists have volunteered to help parents learn how to prevent drug abuse. Visit your local pharmacy, displaying this sign.
A message from Pharmacists Against Drug Abuse.
Every Sunday at noon, the best candlepin bowlers from all over New England set them up and knock them down on Candlepin Stars and Strikes. Join us for three strings of exciting candlepin competition as bowlers try to climb the ladder toward the big prize money. TV 50 Sports puts you right in the middle of the excitement every Sunday at noon on Candlepin Stars and Strikes.
Third seed Carol Downey of Andover goes for it all when she takes on top seed at Tony Marie Brassard from Amesbury on Candlepin Stars and Strikes, Sunday at noon on TV 50.
By popular demand from our television viewers, once again, we have the last 5 minutes or so of the championship match between King Tonga and Dino Bravo. And this is where the action comes in. Watch Bravo take a tremendous shot here to the nose. He almost broke his nose, Gino.
Right, that's where it started, because I've talked to Bravo after that fight, and we've reviewed that tape at least 10 times, and he said that's what stunned him quite good. He came back after that, as the fans will see. But it took a lot out of him, that one big punch.
Well, those of you watching this program know, and you have had, I'm sure, in your lifetime at least, hit your nose once or twice. It brings tears to your eyes. Imagine taking a smash from King Tonga to the nose.
Well, already you can see the blood all over, you know, the nose bleeding profusely. That doesn't help either.
No, sir. And King Tonga, of course, now the AWA champion. I'm sorry, I said AWA champion.
It's
you know,
international champion.
AWA champion, my good friend Ricky Martel.
Right, right. It's all right. Watching that match, you do get nervous. I get nervous myself. And you can see that Bravo, he's still stunned, I mean, and surprised. Because he thought he had his nose broken. I mean, he had tears coming down his eyes. His eyes filled with water, and
that's right.
He had trouble breathing through the nose. He had to breathe through the mouth.
And Tonga here doesn't help with these incredible
elbows.
Look at this.
Ooh, that one.
How Bravo even survived this is beyond me.
Well, this is where Bravo really impressed me right here. As Tonga covers him. 1-2 and
kicked out.
The way he kicked out, he just threw him right off.
Look at this.
And he's up now, and he started getting fired up again. Few punches.
And there he goes.
Now he's getting. That's the Bravo I like to see.
And Tonga here wondering what kind of a madman he's got in front of him. Let me tell you. Look at that.
There. Blood or no blood, broken nose or not, let's go. Let's jam.
Ooh. You know how painful that is. Just following your coccyx at one
covers
time.
Him, and the ref is right there. Count of two, Tonga kicks out.
For those of you who haven't seen this before, you know there's a very controversial ending. It's a very simplistic, but very controversial ending. The referee at one point in time gets hit
right.
And goes down. Otherwise, Bravo might have won.
Kicked out again.
One more time, let's try this coccyx drop, and boy, that has to
and
be painful.
Folks, keep your eyes open to this here.
Boom, Desbois takes a kick to the head. Now listen, we've done it before. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now Bravo all of a sudden spots the fact that Desbois is down. And who gets up to go over and see? Bravo, of course. Slaps him in the face. Are you all right? Yes, he is. Desbois says, I'm okay. Bravo goes back to the action, but look at this.
And he gets caught in a trap, and that's it.
And all of a sudden, King Tonga is the new international wrestling champion of the world. And Bravo, look at this.
You know something, Bob? I've talked to Dino, and it's not because he lost the belt. It's the way he lost the belt that put him down. That's why right now he is in a semi-retirement, because he has to think about what he's going to do next. He sure wants a match against Tonga, and he said he won't wrestle too much till he gets that chance to get that belt back.
Tarzan Tyler pointing out to the crowd that he is the manager of not only King Tonga, the new international wrestling champion of the world, but of course the tag team. I've got them all, he says. And he does. Sailor Moondog and Rick Valentine. So he has to be one of the more successful managers in the world of wrestling.
Right now he's sitting on top of the world.
One more time, you see? Desbois take that kick. And he's out cold.
Now you fans figure it out. With Tonga, if the referee had been there counting, would Tonga have kicked out or not? I doubt it, but
I don't think so.
I don't think so.
I don't think so. I think he's out cold.
Look what he was down. And this is really a bad move on Dean Bravo's part. Coming up with his arms wide open, gets caught.
Watch here, in slow motion. Watch the referee, Desbois. Ooh, a knee, and again, the foot. So, boy, did he ever go down. Now, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Count it as often as you want. I don't think Tonga's going to kick him off. Watch Bravo slap Desbois in the face. Are you okay? I'm okay, says Desbois.
He's okay. Here we see it again. Painful reminder.
Everybody is familiar with this new car sticker. But have you ever gone into a dealer showroom and encountered this? At Groponi Pontiac AMC Jeep, this will never happen to you. Never on our hot-selling Cherokees, CJs, 2000s, not even our Fieros. At Groponi Pontiac AMC Jeep, when we run a sale, we believe you should save money, not spend it on something you'll never use.
I wouldn't be caught dead without my safety belt. I wouldn't be caught dead without my safety belt.
I wouldn't be caught dead without my safety belt.
Will you be caught dead without your safety belt? Each year, nearly 50,000 Americans are. If you don't buckle your belt, maybe someone else will.
As an inspector for the United States Department of Agriculture, it's my job to make sure the meat and poultry at your store is safe, wholesome, and accurately labeled. As a consumer, it's your job to store and prepare it carefully. Keep hot food hot, keep cold food cold, keep food and utensils clean. For more information, write Food Safety, Washington, D.C., 20250.
Tonight, for some, it meant freedom. For some, it meant death. But for Charles Bronson, it became a one-man battle.
Why would anyone kill for aliens?
Oh, come on, Malcolm. For the money, times have changed. It's a big business now.
Someday this may be legitimate. We'll be listed on a commodities exchange.
Yeah, trading in wetback futures.
Wetback doesn't have a future.
Borderline, tonight at 8 on TV50.
He's going to get a surprise. Ray's in back in the ring.
He got caught. Into the turnbuckle. One more time. Ooh, that smart set the cobwebs back into operation right away. Bockwinkel now very punishing to Ray Rougeau. Going for the pin. One, two.
Never happened. All right.
Kicks out.
Nothing more than that. Keep Rougeau down.
Into the ropes goes Rougeau. Over he goes. He landed very lightly, like a cat. Bockwinkel will try it again.
Oh, and rolls him up for a count. One, two.
Oh, Bockwinkel had to use just about all the experience he has to get out of that one. That normally is just about all there is. That usually is a pinhold, isn't it, Gino?
Oh, no, it's not. I knew it. Trying that same move twice. Now, that's a no-no. Bockwinkel read it.
You can do that to inexperienced wrestlers, but you can't do that twice to make Bockwinkel.
He just let him go with it and stopped him halfway.
Into the ropes. Whoa.
Nice cross-body block. Saved again.
I keep sitting here on the edge of my seat, Gino, and sure that any one of these pins is going to be it. And you know the importance of this match is incredible.
It's a 30-minute match, and from what we've seen last week and we're seeing this week, 25 minutes, the ring, the house announcer just announced. So that means that they got 5 minutes to do the job. A lot can happen in 5 minutes.
It sure can. A lot can happen in 10 seconds in this sport. One, two, Bockwinkel pushes Rougeau off at the last possible second. Both these gentlemen tired now, 25 minutes of wrestling. Plays a heavy role to anybody. Bolton down.
Referee counting.
This is Shades of Rocky II. Do you remember when both boxers went down in the movie?
Yes.
Both these gentlemen trying to come up. Bockwinkel is up. Ooh, takes a hard punch to the midsection from Rougeau. Another shot to the jaw, and he's on his back. And he is fuzzy now. Look out. One, two, three. Oh.
Look at that clever move of Bockwinkel. He pushes Raymond's leg out under the rope.
And they brought that.
And he saves himself a pin.
So now you see the experience, of course, of Bockwinkel.
Right.
Both these gentlemen very tired. Into the ropes goes Rougeau.
Oh, caught in an abdominal stretch.
This could be it. This is a submission hold, although it'll take a lot to make Rougeau give up, believe me.
Take a lot, and we're 27, 28 minutes into the match. They can't have the strength that they had and the stamina that they had at first.
Dayboy checking. One of the better referees in the wrestling circuit today, checking nonstop. You can watch him. Are you okay? Do you give up? Do you quit? Bockwinkel has a good hold here. It's a good hold. I don't think Rougeau will give up. Oh, and he certainly is not going to give up.
And he gets Bockwinkel in that abdominal stretch. Now, it could be a different story because Rougeau's a younger man.
That's right.
And the more time goes, the more chances he has of winning.
The pain, you can see the pain. It's a very, very painful hold. Stretches all the muscle inside of your...
And he took him over. I'm sure he's hurt. He has to be hurt. As a matter of fact, both of them look hurt to me.
A lot of punishment. Whoever gets up first here could have it. Bockwinkel just
go
laying
for the count.
On
one, two.
Rougeau's foot is
out. Very exciting match so far. It's been nip and tuck all the way.
That's right. Pull. The punch with all the body weight behind it. And Bockwinkel's hurt his hand.
Missed that.
That's right. Now Rougeau, a punch to the rib cage.
Right.
Ooh, three of them in a row. You know, I can almost feel those here, Gino. Picked them up by the hair.
I wonder why Ray won't try to put on the sleeper or something like that when he's got Bockwinkel groggy. He must, sometimes, you know, it's easy for us to talk here for like,
that's right.
For me right now. And when I'm in that ring, a lot of things I should do, I don't do either.
Well, Rougeau can still pick... Oh, that's a very painful drop.
Saved by the ropes again.
Now, Bockwinkel's got his foot out.
Oh, a nice suplex coming up. That's right. This time, I can't see Bockwinkel. Was he going to kick out? Yes, he does.
He calls on every piece of strength he has left in his body. And he kicks out, then he punches, and they both punch. And they're down
back
on their
and
knees,
forth, back and
away.
Forth.
Who's going to get up first? Bockwinkel.
He got fooled there.
Did he ever? I thought that was it again. That's,
it's a draw.
These people have been exchanging blows and exchanging holds.
Right.
For the entire 30 minutes, it's over. It's
they're
a draw.
They're going at it again. Who's going to break that up now?
That's all, says Desbois. 30 minutes of wrestling.
Here comes Andre Roy and Desbois. They'll bring it up. They'll listen to the referees.
Well, a good match by both these gentlemen. No winner is being declared. So we'll have to do this all over again at one point, Gino.
I, for one, would like to see a rematch of these two. So it has to be settled one way or another.
Because of you.
How would you like to enjoy again 50 of the most loved records of your life? Here they are.
It was fascinating.
Every one of these million-seller recordings can be yours.
You, you, you.
All the chapel bells were ringing.
Come where my love return to me.
These are the giant hits you'll never forget.
Chances are
you'll have to go.
Just walking in the rain.
Only you.
Every record is full length.
I was dancing with my darling.
On Blueberry Hill.
Roses are red, my love.
50 beloved stars.
We're too young.
Make the world.
50 of the most loved records of your life. You get all 50 recordings on your choice of three long-playing records, cassettes, or 8-track tapes. And the price, only $19.98, just $6.66 each. Be sure to order now.
Mail 1998 to 50 Hits, Box 5000, Derry, 03038. You get 50 of the most loved records of your life on three records, three 8-track tapes, or three cassettes for only $19.98. This offer will end with no advance notice, so don't delay. Write this address down now. Mail 1998 to 50 Hits, Box 5000, Derry, New Hampshire, 03038. That's 50 hits. Box 5000, Derry, New Hampshire, 03038.
If you ever wanted to sell wrestling meat by the pound, it's here right now. Abdullah the Butcher, 440 pounds. Isn't he an incredibly huge man?
Well, I'll tell you, Bob, Joe LeDuc usually dwarfs everybody at 300 some odd pounds, but next to Abdullah, he doesn't look too big. He's giving away close to 140 pounds to
him. Can you imagine that? 140 pounds giving away.
Nailed him good there. Could see that Abdullah took that punch and he rolls out of the ring. He knows he shouldn't stay in there and take another one.
Joe LeDuc, if I told you, was one of my favorites and has been for a long time. Back to the days of the LeDuc brothers.
Right, of the LeDuc brothers. As you know, his brothers retired from wrestling, and Joe keeps the family name going by wrestling anybody and anytime. He's wrestled some of the biggest names in the wrestling game, and he always came out on top. He's one of the top men going around in the country.
He's tough, and he's rough, and he can wrestle. He knows an awful lot about the game. And he'll fight anybody, as you've mentioned.
He would. Well, he's fighting Abdullah right now, and I can tell you for a fact, I mean, I've turned down matches against Abdullah because, I mean, I can't see myself getting crippled, because you know that Abdullah will do anything in a wrestling ring. To him, it's not a wrestling match, it's a war.
Look at
now, he's got...
Abdullah's got something in his hand.
It looks like a bowel opener, and he hits LeDuc with it. Now, what if he gets him in the eye with that? I mean, it's all over.
I can't see what he's got from here, Gino. It's something
metal. It looks like one of them can openers or something, or bowel openers.
He has hit Joe LeDuc right in the head with it. He still has it. The referee doesn't see it, obviously. He's hit him again with it. I can't believe... I don't think I've ever seen this from ringside. He's got this thing hanging out of his belt. Joe LeDuc is cut.
Can a guy like that be searched or what? Now he throws him out of the ring.
This is amazing. I almost...
And that's right. Abdullah will follow because that's his strategy. He'll go out after LeDuc and really punish him. Now, you can't call that wrestling, Bob.
No, there's no way he's going to win anything out there, that's for sure.
What's he doing now? Using a chair on LeDuc.
Abdullah,
now, you really have to be lenient if you're the referee of that match to let things like that go by.
He's not finished yet.
And he's not finished yet. And he comes back and...
Look out.
Bangs him on the table.
Moves the timekeper. He's going to hit him with a microphone.
What's he going to hit him now with? With the microphone. I can see some blood on Joe LeDuc.
LeDuc is cut. There's no doubt about that. He's been hit with a chair. A microphone. And God knows what. I don't know what Abdullah the Butcher has in his belt, but he's got something that has cut LeDuc's head.
Now, there's one guy, even Adrian Desbois is intimidated. I can see by Abdullah. He's not even talking to him. He just stands there and...
It is a bottle opener. That Abdullah the Butcher has a bottle opener. Can you believe that? Joe LeDuc is dazed. He is bleeding profusely.
We'd be better off without a referee in that match and just let him go at it. Now, don't count Joe LeDuc out. He might be bleeding and he's down. He's one of the tough ones. He'll come back. I know he'll come back.
Spent a good part of his youth as a lumberjack.
Right.
Until he found out that he could...
He's a big man. And I know he'll come back. And that's the mistake right there of Abdullah. To let Joe LeDuc recuperate.
Well, you can see the officials at ringside are just don't know what to do. You have a timekeeper over there.
Now, that match could be stopped because of too much blood. If the referee...
Joe LeDuc is dazed. He was cut. And now the Butcher trying to slam him down still. I'd be intimidated, too, if I was that referee, Gino.
I would be by Abdullah, yes, especially the size. But still, I mean, he's the law. He just has to ring the bell and that's it.
Joe LeDuc is bleeding quite a bit
profusely right now. Oh, look at the blood.
The pen is mightier than the sword and a lot safer to carry in your pocket. So prior to retailing our pens in the USA, we, the Italian Pen Corporation, invite you to try the Maestro, a designer fountain pen with metal barrel and cap. This golden nib is tough, but it's pressure sensitive too. The controlled ink flow reacts to either a heavy or light hand. Each unit is guaranteed never to leak. There's a double cartridge ink system. It's like having a built-in spare. Why pay $50 or even $40 for a pen? Your price in this promotion is just $19.99. And if that was just for the Maestro, you'd have tremendous value. But it's not. With each Maestro pen comes this superb executive pen with a matching metal barrel, plus a fine liner. This ingenious pen writes on glass, metal, even plastic bags. There's a professionally styled drafting pencil with a gravity lead feed system, plus a built-in point sharpening feature. Also, this compact pocketbook pen that simply extends into a balanced writing instrument. Yes, that's the Maestro, plus four matching pieces for just $19.99. But look, there's more. A fountain pen, executive pen, fine liner, rollerball, and drafting pencil. Ideal for the student in your home. Plus, as a further incentive, this magnificent 20-piece collection with 20 different colored inks. Put one by the phone, one in the car. They'll keep the kids happy for hours. Not $19.99 for the Maestro or for the 5-piece set. Not even for both sets. You get all 30 pieces for $19.99. So you don't forget, order right now and receive our incredible full refill pack. Enough for every pen in the offer. Yes, you get all these quality instruments and the refill pack for just $19.99. Order now. For COD and credit card orders, call toll-free 1-800-453-1900. Save the COD charges by sending $19.99 plus $3 shipping and handling to Pens, Box 5000, Derry. Demand for this fine quality 30-piece designer pen collection will be incredible. So order now.
Miss Ryan complaining her hair's been pulled, as Miss Ryan actually is pulling hair herself. Walter Kowalski takes a walk around. He sees it, breaks it. Lori Shield takes her to front face lock. Walter Kowalski telling her, watch the choke. Shields taking, applying the pressure. Taking her arm, pushing her up against the rope. Walter Kowalski comes in, exits to the break and gets it. This Ryan complaining, but Walter Kowalski's telling her, I'll referee, you wrestle. Ooh, nice leg dive by Miss Ryan. Takes down Lori Shields. For the count, Walter gets the count of one. One again. Complaining about the hair, and boy, we can see it. So does Walter. He breaks the hold, takes her. She throws her in. Oh, a little kick to the stomach. People complaining about the hair. Another kick to the stomach by Nikki Ryan. Boot to the back, and this Ryan goes for the count. Whoa, where did she get the energy to roll her off? Say it, these girls are in excellent shape. They might look dainty, but they're rough cookies. But yet, this Lori Shields, Jody Shields, she possesses too. She possesses the roughness, but at the same time, she possesses that beautiful lady's look, and that she has. Very big favorite throughout the wrestling world. This Nikki Ryan is a big woman. Woo, a vicious forearm by Miss Ryan. Takes her into the turnbuckle, rams her head into the turnbuckle. Walter Kowalski warning her, get him out of the corners. You're talking a lot of weight here. Walter Kowalski coming in for the break and does so. She takes her by the hair, flips her over. I can see why this lady is the woman champion. She is a rough woman. Walter Kowalski breaks. She might have a little trouble here tonight, but she's not getting away with too much here with Walter Kowalski. applies more of a choke hold. Walters warning her, watch the choke. Nikki Ryan telling Walter, take a walk. She better watch how she talks with him. Walter Kowalski warning both wrestlers. Turn around, warning both ladies. Nice takedown by Miss Jody Shields. Right away, Nikki Ryan puts a foot on a rope. I've invited a wrestling fan out of the audience. I'd like you to introduce yourself to the wrestling.
Steve Cabrera, Brunswick, Maine.
Brunswick, Maine. Steve, what do you think about international championship wrestling?
It's nice to have it back in the area of Portland. It's been a long time since, you know, the live ref has been around here, like I say, and you got some of the best. You got the King Tongas, the Backlunds coming in, the Brito Jr. and Senior. I tell you, the talent is just—it's unbelievable.
Some it's really coming in. What do you think about these ladies? I tell you, that Miss Shields is a pretty-looking lady.
She's a nice looker. She's giving away a lot of weight, but she's a gameable young girl.
Yes, she is.
Again, if I had her sister in my corner, I'll be getting awful kid.
I tell you, her sister—I'm not—I'm not too sure myself, but I think her sister might just be a little bit bigger than this Nikki Ryan.
I think you're probably right.
Oh, nice reversal there. Oh, I tell you that this Ryan is...
To get hit by a shot like that with a girl that size, that must take a lot out of you.
Whoa, another vicious one, and down goes Shields. I actually can see why this Nikki Ryan is the champion. I think it'd take a lot to beat a woman that size.
She's got the size, and how are you going to get her off her feet, to hold her down for a count?
Yeah, that's definitely true.
Nice to see Killer Kowalski back in the ring.
Isn't it?
It's been a while.
I was told that you really go way back with professional wrestling.
Well, I've been following ever since I was a little kid, of course, and ever since back with the Mongols. And I still remember the night when Killer Kowalski fought Edouard Carpentier back in the middle 60s, I guess it could be.
So you go way back with it, huh?
I followed ever since I was a little fella. Getting the fans going.
This Jody Shields looks like, come on, I'm ready.
She's a little fire plug in there.
She sure is, isn't she? She's a go-getter.
She's got a lot of fire in her. I tell you, to get into the ring with a world champion,
it takes a lot.
You've got to have a lot of guts.
Yeah, it really does. Whoa!
The first rule of professional wrestling, never turn your back.
That's right. I think this Nikki Ryan is just very confident here tonight. I think,
To be a world champion, you have to have all the confidence in the world. I mean, she didn't get that way just by, just by getting in the ring and having something handed to her. She had to work pretty hard for it.
Well, I guess it's like anything else. I'm sure she schooled her opponent, and I've seen her wrestle before. She just seems a little more confident. But then again, the whole trick of the matter is that she has one hell of a referee in there with her tonight, Walter Kowalski, so she's not getting away with too much either.
Nice take down.
Nice take down there by Ms. Shields. I hear your hangout is the Ramada Inn in Lewiston.
Ramada or Lawson? Home away from home.
I've been there many times, and I tell you, I really enjoy it there.
Sue the bartender and the waitresses.
Yeah, there's some pretty waitresses there, I'll tell you that.
They're pretty big fans, too, I'll tell you. That must just make the ears ring.
Oh, boy. Especially with the pressure you have applied there.
I'll tell you what.
My goodness. It's just amazing how this Jody Shields can even get out of when she lays on top of her guy. And she refuses to give her weight besides.
I wonder why.
Yeah.
I guess the ring announcer was earning his money tonight.
Yeah, I tell you, he ran out of there pretty quick, didn't he? Nice maneuver by Shields and gets out of it.
Nice kick out, turn around into a headlock. Rolling her over.
Yeah.
Down to two. Killer Kowalski, you can tell the all the ring experiences.
Yeah, I tell you, I really don't believe that there's a rule that could be broken in there that Walter hasn't broken. So it's going to be very hard for this Miss Ryan to really get away with anything.
He knows them all and he's done them all.
Well, I would say that 90% of them, he's probably the master of them. And I bet you on a good percentage, also the inventor. Looks like a little choke here. Kowalski's going to get down here and check it out. He believes it is. He's just breaking it. There's good judgment on the referee's part. He didn't even wait. He just broke it. This Nikki. Oh, let me tell you something. He'll do it. He'll do it. He'll do it. He'll do it.
Back in the late 60s when he tore off the ear of Yukon Eric in Montreal, Canada, was it?
That's right.
I wouldn't put nothing past him.
I tell you, he was one vicious wrestler. I was talking about him earlier. You can go down a list, and I don't think there's maybe anyone that comes close to the viciousness and the experience of a guy like Walter Kowalski. And you know, I was saying earlier, Steve, that he doesn't even hide the fact that he makes it public that he was the executioner. He wants you to know that was him, you know?
Yeah, one half of the world tag team champion.
Champions of the world, yep. The belts that man held and the places he's been to, unbelievable.
All over the world.
And I tell you, the shape he's in right now, I'd be afraid to go in there now with him.
He doesn't look like he's in too bad a shape.
No, he sure doesn't.
Big man.
I tell you, I notice he has his wrestling shoes on. I wish they could talk. I bet you they could tell you some stories.
I bet you they could.
There's been a few faces that have met the soles of those shoes.
Probably still got a few good blood stains on them.
Yeah. This Nikki Ryan, I tell you what, she's not too favored here.
Oh, Jody Shields took a big boot.
Again, she broke the rule.
You can't turn your back.
I'm watching across the ring. I'm watching the eyes of her sister.
I think that has a little bit to do with a little distraction here and there.
Yeah. Walter Kowalski makes sure that she keeps her distance from him because he wants no interference. This is a championship match.
A little test of strength, I don't know.
There's a kick to the stomach by Miss Shields. She actually turned it around on her there, you know. This crowd's going wild.
Double kick.
Yep, she's got her down to one knee, and that's a lot. Now she's got her down.
Stay on him.
This crowd is going wild.
The way to defeat a big man or a big woman in this case. One way to get out of it, reach for the ropes.
That's it, huh? That's it.
I'll tell you, they're there to hold you in, but you know, they come in handy sometimes.
They sure do. Whips her into the ropes. Tried for a pin. Well, maybe she felt that she didn't have her well enough yet. Here she takes her again, whips her into the ropes. Another elbow. Down she goes for the second time. Got the crowd going with her. She takes her up against the ropes. Down she goes. Oh, look at this. She went right through the rope. She went right through the rope. Referee is counting. Referee's warning her.
I tell you, Joan Shields had her going.
She did. This is where the smartness of a champion comes into effect, because she knows she's counted out. She doesn't lose the title.
Stay outside the ring. That's take as much of the count as you can.
Look at this. Lori Shields taking her, and she throws her right back into the ring.
That's one way to get in there.
She rolls her over. She's going for the pin. One, two, three.
That means we have the title. We have a new champion.
Unbelievable. I don't believe it. The winner of the match and the new ladies heavyweight champion of the world, Miss Jody Shields. Walter Kowalski's not going to present her with the belt.
If your favorite radio station isn't what it used to be, it's time for a new favorite. Light 92.5 FM plays the classics from yesterday, today, and tomorrow in a clean, uncluttered environment. No hype. No gimmicks. No endless chatter. Just light rock with less talk, the way it should be. Judge for yourself. Turn on the light at 92.5 FM.
Everybody is familiar with this new car sticker. But have you ever gone into a dealer showroom and encountered this? At Groponi Pontiac AMC Jeep, this will never happen to you. Never on our hot-selling Cherokees, CJs, 2000s, not even our Fieros. At Groponi Pontiac AMC Jeep, when we run a sale, we believe you should save money, not spend it on something you'll never use.
Now, the floor covering sale that cuts your costs in half. It's Dean's Carpet Spectacular Half Price Sale. Half price on many national brands of carpeting. Half price on color carpet remnants. Half price on a select group of Oriental rugs. And half price on no-wax vinyl. Get half price on Ultron by Monsanto and their exclusive 5-year wear-dated guarantee. Yes, Dean's Carpet has half price savings store-wide. Cut your floor covering costs in half at Dean's Carpet across from the Mall of New Hampshire in Manchester.
The Vietnam War, the war that tore apart our nation. This weekend, more than 300,000 veterans will gather in Washington, D.C. for the dedication of the statue that completes the Vietnam Veterans Memorial. This is Alex Eldridge. This weekend, I'll travel with some 200 New Hampshire vets who will make a pilgrimage to that ceremony to honor, remember, and reflect on that controversial war.
Join Alex Eldridge for his two-part series, The Journey, beginning Monday during TV 50 News at 6 and 10.
That's it this week for International Championship Wrestling. Don't forget to tune in next week for...